Welcome to my first lecture on resistive circuits. In this video, I'll give you a brief introduction to resistive circuits. Now, first of all, I wish to clarify that I will be taking few lectures, a series of lectures, to cover the entire syllabus of circuit theory. So first we will start with resistive circuit, and then we will move to the circuits with resistance, inductor, capacitor, the transient response and AC analysis, all those things. Okay, so please go through my lectures one by one and try to follow it sequentially so that you can understand the future videos easily. Okay, so let us start. Now, the circuits, so these circuit, it basically implies that it's a closed path. Containing some circuit elements, okay, at least voltage, some sources, and other circuit elements like resistance will denote by R, inductance will denote by L, capacitance will denote by C, and also some active devices like BJT, bipolar junction transistors, or MOSFET or FET, several devices we can also include here. Okay, so main concept is that in a closed path, if source is there and some circuit elements is there, then current can flow through the circuit. Okay, one simplest circuit will contain one voltage source and one resistance. Okay, so this source, this is, we'll discuss later in detail. This is a voltage source. Suppose voltage is V, capital V, and its resistance is R. So in this circuit, this closed path, current will flow. Basically, this current is nothing but flow of electrons. Right, so from this negative terminal, the electrons will denote by E. So electrons E is generated, and that E is circulated here, and it is the Faraday plate is accepting that electron. So it's a continuous process. So negative plate will supply the electron, and positive plate will accept those electrons. Okay. So this is a motion of electrons, and electron, you know, it's a negative charge carrier. Okay, so as it's a negative charge carrier and it is flowing in this direction, so convention will take that a current is flowing in the opposite direction of electron flow. That means the current will flow from this to this, from positive plate to the negative plate in the through the circuit. So this is the current, suppose I, is flowing through the circuit. So this is our convention, that whenever there is a flow of electron, current is generated, but current direction is the opposite of the direction of flow of electrons. Okay. Now, this circuit, let us consider, we can consider one network. This is called network, and we can have sources, okay, then we can connect the sources to the network. Okay, and network is basically a circuit or open loop, we can say. Suppose if we don't connect the sources, just it's an interconnection of few elements, network elements, like resistance, or inductance, or capacitance. Okay, and already you said that resistance will denote by capital R, inductance will denote by capital L, and capacitance will denote by capital C. Okay, so network can contain all these elements, or okay, only resistance, or combination of resistance, inductance, all those things. Okay, and whenever we will add one source, that source could be a voltage source or current source. Okay, whenever this one source is connected, or more than one source is connected, then this network is excited. We can guess that, we can assume that current can flow through this line, and through the network also we can have certain currents, right? Now in this video we'll concentrate on resistive circuits, means the network will contain only resistances. Okay, a combination of resistance we'll consider in the network side, and source we can consider voltage or current, all those things, right? So these two, inductance and capacitance, that will be included later. So right now our focus is on resistive circuits, means resistive network with the source. Okay, that is called resistive circuits. Now we'll start from very basics, that is the Ohm's law. Right, so the resistance symbol, we'll consider this one. This is the symbol of resistance, and we'll use capital R to denote this resistance. And using this Ohm's law, we know that if there is a potential difference between these two ends of this resistance, suppose this end is A, this is B, and this potential is BA, and this is your potential is BB, then there is a potential difference. That difference is VA minus VB. So that write as, suppose it's only capital V, that is your capital V. Okay, and if this is a higher potential, VA is a higher potential compared to the VV, then a current will flow from A to B, and that current is capital I. The relation between this current and voltage is this V equals to this current times the resistance R. Okay, this R, the unit of this resistance is ohm. Okay, the main purpose of this resistance is to limit the current in the circuit. That is one use of this resistance. Okay, or to get desired level of current or voltage in a circuit. Right, so using Ohm's law, we'll have this resistance V equals to I times R. Here, you should remember one thing, that whatever the direction of this current through the resistance is, this resistance will always consume power. It will never generate power. Okay, so this is a passive element. It will always consume power. So you see, if this is your resistance R, if the current flow is this side, then we'll assume that this end is having plus potential and this is one negative potential, means this is the higher potential, this is the lower potential, and gap is V. Okay, and the same resistance R, if current is flowing in opposite direction, that is your capital I, again we'll consider that here it is a positive terminal and this is a negative, okay, and this voltage is V, and here we'll call it voltage drop. Okay, so across the resistance always you will get a voltage drop. This is not a source at all, be careful. So it can consume certain power. So power is V times I. Okay, so for this resistance, as you know that V equals to I times R, we can relate as this one, we can replace I as V upon R. In that case, you will get V squared by R, or you can replace this V by I times R. In that time, you will get I squared into R. Both are valid, but always it will consume power. Okay, so here you will take one assumption. Okay, so whenever current is entering into the positive terminal, then the device will consume power. Okay, and it is different from a source. Suppose if I have a source like this voltage source, this is your positive terminal of a voltage source and this is a negative terminal voltage source. And purpose of this voltage source is to generate current. So whenever some element will be added to this source is connected, like suppose if I connect a simple resistance here, we'll get a current here through the resistance R. So here you see from plus terminal current is leaving, and if this potential is capital V, so this source will generate power, and that value is V times I. So this is a source. This will generate power, and the resistance, it will consume the power. Okay, so we'll come to this point later, that in a circuit, total power generated by the sources will be same as the total power consumed by resistances, if it is a resistive circuit only. Okay, now let us first consider the sources. So different kind of sources. So broadly we'll have two type of sources. One is voltage source. Other one is current source. Okay, And voltage source, that could be a DC or constant voltage it can provide. And that we write in this way. This is a symbol for a DC voltage source. Or we can use this symbol, the plus one circle, and within the circle we can put plus and minus sign. So these two are used to indicate DC voltage source, right? And we can have alternating voltage source, AC one, and for that we'll use this symbol. Okay, so this, it could be, we can write alternating current like a sinusoidal, A cos omega naught t, like that. This is a sinusoidal source. It will alternate the, it will oscillate from positive to negative like that. Okay, this is your AC source, voltage source. Right. So we'll use capital V to indicate its magnitude, or we can write V sub S to indicate it is a source. That's better. So its purpose is to provide a constant voltage in a network. Okay, for the DC voltage source. Similarly, for current source, we'll use this symbol. Okay, so this is the direction of current. Remember, this arrow is given here is the direction of current, means current I is flowing in this direction. Right, so this is a DC current source. Similarly, you will have AC current source like this, and again, we'll put some arrow to indicate that it is a AC current source. But of course, in AC current source, there is no meaning of direction because it will change your direction continuously, right? So these are the symbols to use voltage source and current source. But these are called independent sources, okay? As their magnitudes are independent of other circuit parameters. So they will provide a constant voltage or a constant current. Okay? Now we'll find sometimes dependent sources. So dependent sources. So we'll use this type of symbol to indicate dependent source. Okay. So it could be voltage source, it could be current source. Okay. Suppose if I consider this is plus, this is minus, that means it is basically voltage source, but its magnitude will depend on other circuit parameters. Suppose if I say it is a 3i, where I is a current in other branches, and that should be given, right? So this is your current dependent voltage source. This could be called a current controlled or current dependent voltage, current controlled voltage source. Okay, similarly, I can have a voltage source depending on the voltage of other circuit parameters. Okay, Suppose if I call it 5V, where V is the voltage across certain elements in the network, right? So I'll give you one example later. So this is your, I can write voltage controlled, in short, so this is in short current controlled voltage source, CCVS. And this is your voltage controlled and voltage source, right? And similarly, you can have current source right, but this magnitude may depend on other current. Suppose it's 2i, then it will be called the current controlled, it is a current source because it is controlled by this current I and it's basically a current source. Similarly, I can have a current source, I'll put the arrow to indicate the direction, and its magnitude, suppose it, if it is 4 times V and V is the voltage across other elements, then it will be voltage controlled current source. Okay, now let us take one example, just one take one example. Suppose if I consider this kind of circuit, okay, and suppose this is your current source. Now you see, this is, circle indicates that it is a constant voltage source, and suppose its value is given as 10 volt, and its resistance is 2 ohm, suppose it is 4 ohm, it is 5 ohm, it is suppose 7 ohm, and if this current source is suppose 2 ampere, and if this voltage across this 7 ohm is small v, and then this current source, okay, its magnitude is suppose your 8 V. So in this case, this one is your dependent source, and it is depending on the voltage on this element, 7 ohm resistance, like the voltage across 7 ohm resistance. Thus, this circuit is containing one dependent source. It is basically the voltage controlled current source. Okay. And this type of control source you will find whenever you will consider some active elements in a circuit like BJT, MOSFET, okay, bypass junction transistors or MOSFET. So these are modeled with some dependent current source or voltage sources. Okay. So we'll discuss the circuits with dependent sources as well, but let us first concentrate on independent voltage source resistive circuits. That means, so we'll consider first one we'll consider DC sources. Okay, so it may be dependent and independent sources, or both we'll consider. Then these DC sources will be connected to a network. Okay, and this is your resistive network. Okay, and the resistive network can have some combination of resistances only. We'll not consider right now inductance and capacitance, all those things. Okay, and here we'll consider only DC sources like DC voltage source or DC current source. So this one we'll start with. Okay, so let us now consider first this resistive network. Okay, and you see the connections of resistances could be in several way, either they are simply connected in series or in parallel or in complicated manner, right? Okay, so this if I consider one series network or series circuit, series connection there of resistances. Okay, so if I have few resistances, they are connected in series. This is R1, R2, R3, and they will be called that they are connected in series if and only if a single current is flowing through the elements, all the elements. Okay, same current is flowing, means that the second resistance should be connected to the first one at this point. Okay, this will be connected one after another, right? So this is called series connection. So here there should not have any branching. That's one important thing. And now we can find out equivalent resistance of these resistances, right? So how to find the resistance? So if this is the network, I can connect one source with this network, right? So this source is Vs, and if it is supplying one current, that current is I, right? So this same current is I is flowing through the circuit only, right? So the impedance of it, so we can take one equivalent circuit that there is a equivalent resistance R EQ that is connected with the same source Vs, V sub S, and it will provide the circuit current I again. So from here we understand that the relation is Vs equals to I times R equivalent by Ohm's law, is right? Now here also we can find out, because you see this total supply voltage is Vs. Now whenever there is a current is flowing through resistances, we have said that by Ohm's law a potential drop will appear across resistance. So voltage across this R1 is suppose V1, and voltage across R2 is V2, and voltage across R3 is V3. And you know that V1 is I times R1, and V2 it's I times R2, and V3 it's I times R3. So total supply voltage V will be shared among these three. Okay, so we can have an equation that the supply voltage Vs equals to this V1 drop plus V2 drop plus V3 drop. Okay, so simply we can replace here this IR1, IR2 plus IR3. So we can now take common, this is R1 plus R2 plus R3. So you see, now we can equate these two. If we equate these two equations, this one and this one, easily we can say that this R equivalent is simply addition of these three, R1 plus R2 plus R3. And it's implied that whenever resistance are connected in series, they'll offer more resistance. Okay, and they are additive. The total resistance will increase the addition of this one. Okay. So we can generalize this one that in a series circuit, if we have more than two, more than one resistances, like after this. This is R1, R2, R3, up to Rn. Okay, so we can replace this network by single resistances, equivalent resistance, that is possible, and that value is simply a summation of all resistances. So we'll write Ri and I equals to 1 to capital N. It's implied it is R1 plus R2 plus R3 up to Rn. Right. Now, similarly, similar to this one, we can have a parallel connection. Of resistances, right? Suppose if I have a network like this, okay. Now with this network, this resistance is suppose R1, this is R2, this is R3. Now you see all the resistance, they are connected in two ends, okay. This is the end A, this is the end B, okay. And they will share the same potential because at this point, end A, some potential will be there, so that potential I can call it VA, and at this point, the potential is VV. So each resistance will have same potential difference VA minus VV. Now, if I connect one source, V with this network. So you see, this was our network. Okay, basically it is a parallel connection of resistances, right? Now, if I assume that the current, this is supply voltage Vs, and it will provide a current capital I, suppose. So now, this VA minus VB will be simply V because there is no more draw in this circuit. Only resistances will have some draws. So the node potential VA would be same potential as positive terminal, and node potential VB is same potential as negative terminal. So gap between these two is VS only, right? So current through the resistance R1 is suppose I1, and current through R2 is I2, and current through R3 is I3. So you see, we can write I1 equals to the voltage by resistance, so Vs upon R1 through R1 resistance. Okay, similarly, the I2 is Vs by R2, and I3 is simply Vs upon R3. And you see, total current supplied by the source is capital I, that you have considered. So this total current I is now divided in these three branches. So obviously, the total current I will be same as the addition of these three, I1 plus I2 plus I3. Now, if I replace this I1 plus I2 plus I3 here, then what will get? So total current I is now I1 is Vs upon R1, and this is Vs upon R2, and this is Vs upon R3. Okay, so now here I can take Vs common. So this is 1 upon R1, 1 upon R2, plus 1 upon R3. Now this network, okay, this one, I can take an equivalent one, only single resistances. So this three resistances, they are connected in parallel, that we can consider it with a single resistance R equivalent, but we wish to get the same effect. Means if I connect a source here with the voltage source Vs, and if we get a current supplied by the source is capital I, then for this equivalent resistance, if I connect the same source Vs, it should provide the same current I. That imply this current I is again Vs upon R equivalent. Now if I compare these two, so this one and this one, okay, so first one is I equals to Vs by this one, so comparing these two easily we can say that it is 1 upon R equivalent is equals to 1 upon R1, 1 upon R2, plus 1 upon R3. Right? Now, this one, you can generalize it. So, if I have more than this one, then 1 upon R equivalent could be in this form, the summation of 1 upon Ri, where I equals to 1 to capital N, if there are n number of resistances connected parallelly. Okay, and for two cases, if I have only two elements, they connected parallelly. Okay, don't consider this one. This is R1, this is R2. Then you see, for this one, 1 upon R equivalent is 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. So you can simplify it. It's R1 times R2, and here it is again R1 plus R2. Okay. So thus, R equivalent is very simple. For these two resistances, they are connected parallelly. That is R1 into R2 upon R1 plus R2. That means product of two resistances upon sum of two resistances. Okay. So, if I consider two resistances, one is 6 ohm, one is 3 ohm. So, for this, R equivalent we can compute easily as 6 times 3 upon 6 plus 3. So, this is 18 upon 9, it is a 2 ohm. Okay. And if they are equal, okay, if both the resistances are same, both are R and R, then you see R equivalent will be R times R upon R plus R. So it is R square upon 2R. So 1R will cancel out, so you will get R by 2. It's a half of that. So that you should use it regularly, okay? So whenever you will get equal one, we can just simplify as it is a R by 2. And we can generalize this one. If we have, suppose so all are, so 4 ohm, there are 4 resistances, all are 4 ohm, then you will see that its R equivalent will be simply this resistance 4 upon 4 is 1 ohm. Okay. And if it is, suppose, instead of 4 resistances, if you are having 10 resistances, so if we have 10 resistances with 4 ohm each and they are connected parallelly, and in that case it will be simply 4 by 10 means 0.4 ohm. So that you can compute easily, because 1 upon 4, 1 upon 4, 10 times 10 upon 4, and it is reciprocal of 10 by 4. Okay, so it means 4 by 10, it's 4.4 ohm. So that you should check, right? And sometimes we'll get some complicated network, right? Like okay, this is suppose 5 ohm. Now from this A and B, I want to find equivalent resistance for this network. Okay, and this is suppose 3 ohm, it is 6 ohm, and this is suppose on all are 6 ohms. Okay, now here with this 5 ohm, this 3 ohm is not in series circuit, because whatever current is coming through this 5 ohm, now here we'll have a branching. Okay, one is through 3 ohms, other one is through 6 ohms. But one thing you can say, that this 3 ohms and 6 ohms, these two, they are connected parallelly because their ends, two ends are same. So first we can simplify these two, 3 and 6 ohm, they are connected parallelly. And similarly, 6, this 3, also we can consider that they are connected parallelly. Okay, so we can simplify this thing as, this is your 5 ohm as it is. Now 6, 3 and 6 parallel connection, 3 into 6 upon 3 plus 6, that will give you 2 ohm. Okay, so that is connected here. Now 6 ohm, 6 ohm, 6 ohm, all are 6 ohm, and 3, they are parallelly connected, so it is 6 up by 3, that is your 2 ohm. Okay, so that is also a 2 ohm resistance. Now you see, between this A and B, this 3, 5, 2 and 2, they are connected in series because same current will be flowing through this one. So our equivalent will be simply 5 plus 2 plus 2 means 4, it's 9 ohm. Okay, so we can simplify it. However, if circuit is a little bit complicated, sometimes like this, okay, and suppose I have one more element here. So this is the two end, A and B. And this resistance, suppose RA, or R1, rather. R1, it is R2, this is R3, this is R4, and this resistance is R5. Now you can notice here that this R1 and R3, not connected parallelly. As suppose they are living from same node, same point, but they are not ending at the same point, because here potential will be different. So this potential and this potential will be defined. So if I call it C and it is this point is D, so BC and BD, they could be the different one. Okay, and if they are same, then okay, we can consider. So in the so in that case, this R5 is zero, suppose, then BC and BD could be same. Okay, and R1 and R3 could be parallel connected. Similarly, this R1 and R2, they are not connected in series because of this bunching through the resistance R5. So R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, they are not neither connected in series or not connected in parallel. So don't consider that resistance will be either connected series or parallel. It's not the case. Okay, so you have to be very, very sure about this connection. I have said that in a series circuit, the same current will be flowing. You should understand same current. In a parallel circuit, same voltage across, okay? Same voltage across the element. That is the requirement. If you have the same voltage across the elements, then they are connected parallelly. And if you find the same current flowing through the all the resistances, then resistances, they are connected in series. And they are connected one after another, obviously. Okay? So this is about the connections of resistances in the network. Now, I'll come to this point, the sources again. Okay? Now, I said that sources could be either DC voltage source or DC current source, right? So here we are considering only, right now we are considering DC sources. Now this DC voltage source you see, the main purpose of this DC voltage source is to provide a constant voltage to a network. So this is our network. Okay. So whenever you will connect a source, DC source BS, it will try to provide a constant voltage across the network. And rather, it will try to provide the same voltage VS across the network. So if this is the ideal voltage source, then obviously you will get the same potential VS across the network, whatever current it is flowing to the network here. However, if the source is a practical one, not ideal, then if you connect this source to a network, that network here, okay, you may not find the same potential across this one. If the supply voltage is Vs, you may get different potential V across the network, okay, some loss of voltage. And that is denoted by some internal resistance of the source. So practical voltage source can have certain internal resistance, RS. Okay, so whenever some current is flowing to this circuit, I, some voltage drop across resistance will be there. And that is your I times RS, that is a loss. And rest will be available across the network. So easily you can say that this voltage V is Vs minus I times Rs. So here we will consider that this current is supplied by the source and that is positive. We'll assume this thing, and this is true if the network is having positive resistances. Okay, Sometimes we can have negative resistance, that will be discussed later. Right? So if this current flow, if source is generating some current I, then due to internal resistances, some losses will be there. So that is Vs minus Is. So you will get this V, which is less than Vs. So you see, we can get an ideal voltage source. Or for this ideal voltage source, you see this Rs should be zero, close to zero. So for practical voltage source as well, you should have the internal resistance as low as possible. Then only you will get maximum voltage across the network. Right? Very similar thing for DC current source. And one thing I want to mention that these DC voltage sources are available in the market. You can say it's a battery simply. We can purchase it. However, DC current source, generally it is not available in market. But we can generate. So DC current source. So the symbol, you know, we'll use this arrow to indicate that current flow, this is the direction of current flow, right? So this is the I sub S. So its purpose is to provide a constant current to a network. So if this is the network, okay, so if you connect this one to this, so you will find a voltage across the network is V, and the current entering the network, that is the I, and that will be same as Is, because there is no losses at all if it is an ideal current source. However, if it is not ideal, then what will happen? Suppose if you connect to this network with this current source, suppose this is not ideal, then you can't expect that you will get the same current entering in this network. Okay, some loss of current you can expect. And that is denoted by one parallel path across this current source, that is called leakage resistance or source resistance. So I'll call it R sub S. It's a leakage resistance, a leakage current through these resistances Rs, and rest will be available for this network. So this current I is entered through the network. And suppose the voltage across the network, this time it's capital V. So this potential and this potential across this Rs is same. It is V again. So leakage current will be V upon Rs. Okay. So this Is is coming here and some current is leaking here through this resistance, and rest will be available here. So the current available for this network I is Is minus the leakage, and leakage is V upon Rs. And we will assume that again this V is positive, and if V is positive, leakage current is downward, it's some kind of less than leaking one. Okay, so in that case I should be less than Is. So this is for practical current source, right? And you see, this ideal current source, it should have a resistance Rs, which is ideally infinite. So ideal current source is having a source resistance infinity, and practical current source can have some finite resistance, but it should be as high as possible. Then only it is better, and you will get almost the same current as I is. Right? Now, we'll just introduce two more things. One is potential divider. So if I have a potential across these two points, right, and this potential is capital V, now if I connect few resistances in series, okay, suppose three resistances R1, R2, R3. Now if I want to understand what is the potential across R2, so this potential is our V2. So total potential is V, and this total potential will be shared in the three series resistances R1, R2, R3, and how they are connected. So what is the exact potential V2 across the resistance R2? So how to compute? We'll assume that current through the circuit is capital I. So in that case, the potential drop across R1 is I times R1, and across this one, so this is your V1, and R2 is V2, I times R2, and across R3 it's a V3. Okay, so V1 is I times R1, and V2 is I times R2, and V3 is I times R3. So total voltage V is simply summation of these three, I times R1 plus I times R2 plus I times R3. So from here I can find I. I is V upon R1 plus R2 plus R3. Okay, so then we can easily find out the voltage across the resistance R2, that is your I into R2, and we can rewrite as this is R2 upon R1 plus R2 plus R3 times V. So the potential across any resistance will be the self resistance. So this is your self resistance, okay, and this is your sum of all resistances multiplied by supply volt potential. Okay, that is very easy to find out. So for example, okay, so this is 1 ohm, this is 3 ohm, this is our 6 ohm. So if I want to find the potential across this 6 ohm, and suppose this total potential is 30 volt, so this potential V0 is, suppose the self resistance is 6, by total 1 plus 3 plus 6 and times this total supply voltage is 30. So it is 6 upon 10, 30, so you will get 18 volt. It's very easy to compute, right? So we can extend. So it is not only limited for three resistances, we can connect n number of resistances in series, but this we can apply potential divider. Next one is current divider. Suppose if you have a current, total current I flowing here, then it is divided among few resistances like this. I'll consider only three. So this is R1, R2, R3. Now I wish to find out what is the current through this resistance I2, that is suppose I2. Right? So here what we'll do, I'll consider that potential across all the elements is capital V. So current through R1, that is your I1, is nothing but V upon R1. Current through resistance R2 is V upon R2. Current through resistance R3 is V upon R3 by Ohm's law. Okay, so total current I, easily I can write, is the current through R1 is V upon R1 plus current through R2 is V upon R2, and this is V upon R3. Okay, so easily we can find V. V is I upon 1 upon R1, 1 upon R2, plus 1 upon R3. Okay, and that we can write as I upon Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3, where Yi equal to 1 upon Ri, that is your conductance. This is your conductance, where Ri is resistance. Its unit is ohm and its unit is mho. Okay, just opposite of that one that we will consider. Reciprocal of resistance is the conductance. Okay, so it's fine. Now, what is your current I2? I2 is nothing but V upon R2. Again, V up V into 1 upon R2. So 1 upon R2, I can write Y2 times V. So you see, this is Y2 upon Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 times V. So we will get a very similar result, like a potential divider, but here we have to consider the self conductance upon total conductance times supply voltage. Sorry, total supply current. Okay, be careful. So this is your V upon R2. So V, we replace these things. Okay, what will be? So this is your current, total supply current. Right, and for only two cases, suppose if I have only two elements, then we can little bit simplify it. So this is R1, it is R2. So I want to find out the I2 current, if total current is I. So I2, you see, this its conductance is 1 upon R2, its total conductance is 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 times total current I. And if you simplify it, this R1 R2 and this is R1 plus R2, R2 will cancel out, you will get R1 upon R1 plus R2 times I. No? So here it is just opposite of potential divider in two cases. Okay, so it is opposite resistance. This R2, the opposite is R1. And by total resistances. So if it is only two elements, in that case only we can simplify it in that way. Suppose, for example, if I can have a circuit like this, and if it is suppose 2 ohm, and it is suppose 4 ohm, total current is 10 ampere, then current through 4 ohm, that I, easily we can find out the opposite resistance is 2 upon total 2 plus 4, right, times 10. So if you simplify it, it will be 3, it is 10 upon 3 ampere. Is this correct? So this is your potential current divider. So we have discussed so far the current divider and potential divider, and we will discuss more problems. So this is just a brief introduction about this course. Please continue to watch my videos, and if you like, please subscribe my channel so that you can get my future videos. Thank you.